Hey guys, Berinfos here, and this is the GTA Vice City Winter Mod. Let's begin! Let's watch this first introduction.
I poke my head out of the gutter for one freaking second and fate shovels shit in my face. Go get some sleep. What are you gonna do?
So this mod adds sliding. As you can see, this guy is even affected by the sliding. Yeah, even in cutscenes people are affected.
I'll drop by your office tomorrow and we can start sorting this mess out.
And here we go, he arrived safely and soundly. Sometimes though he just drives for a few minutes, like 2 minutes even, drives around trying to hit the mark where he has to end up, but no. This time it was pretty quick. So this mod adds sliding and also winter. Winter is here guys, and I wanna make a winter mod video, not only one video though. This is gonna be like probably 4 or 5 videos. This is gonna be a full complete playthrough of the entire GTA game without any proper, you know, preparations. No preparations have been made for these videos. From start to finish I'm gonna play blind. Well, it's not blind because I have completed the game at 100% multiple times, but still I haven't played in maybe a year or a year and a half since my last walkthrough on this game. So I have forgotten many things about the game, but this is gonna be a full playthrough. I hope you enjoy, and yeah, I hope you stick around through all the videos. This is gonna be so cool. The first episode, also this is not live, no, this is post, I'm recording this on post, this is post commentary. I have already completed this episode, and I'm just talking over the recorded footage. And yes, my driving is atrocious, I know that. Also, this was the first time I played this mod, completely blind. And I didn't know some changes, so there's some changes with this mod. Not only the sliding, look at me, trying to jump. These guys are actually police officers, and they're so abundant, they're absolutely everywhere. Also, as you can see, I screwed up here. At the start of this mission, I got 2 stars. For nothing. I did not know that these people are police officers. I thought he was just angry. An angry pedestrian. But no, he's actually a police officer. Which is a shame. It's a real shame because this mod is awesome, but the overabundance of police officers is enormous.
Nice bite.
I don't like it. Also, this mod suffers from pop-in. The original game does not suffer from that, but this one does. Also, I killed another police officer, which is also a mistake. I got cleared, my wanted level got cleared, and I did it again. I brought it back again. So let's go to the pier, or let's try to go to the pier. So this is the GTA game I know the least about from the GTA 3 era. This is the one with the least knowledge I have about, but I still have completed it at 100%, but I'm not that familiar with all the mission structure, all the missions, how to do them exactly. I know how to do them exactly and whatnot, but you know,
maybe
I'm not that familiar with it as I am with GTA 3 or Vice City.
It's so difficult having a rich and powerful father. Vamos.
Should I talk over the NPCs? I think I should. I mean, I'm skipping all the cutscenes. You don't need to watch the cutscenes because I show them off in my walkthrough. In my opinion, it's not required.
See you around, handsome.
Yeah, it's not required to watch all the cutscenes.
I'm sure you will.
I don't know. Also, the download link will probably be in the description. Or you can also check out my GTA 3 Winter Mod videos playthrough. It was in 3 parts. This mission, this game is longer, so it's gonna have more parts, but the GTA 3 playthrough of the winter mod had 3 parts. And they're very cool. That mod is better than this one. I'm not very impressed with this one because it does not look better. Now with the winter mod in GTA 3, the game looks a lot better. The draw distance, the gameplay feels a little different and better. But here the gameplay is worse because of all the police officers. And this is Miami. Miami does not work well with snow. The roads are bland and whatnot. So yeah, it's not the best mod out there, but it's a winter mod. It adds lighting and, you know, it feels good. It feels great still, but it's not that amazing as a GTA 3 one, so yeah, you can play it if you want to. You can watch my GTA 3 playthrough. Oh, dude, that was close. Okay, watch out here. And some vehicles handle terribly, while others handle pretty good. The PCJ handles absolutely atrocious. It's a very bad vehicle to use. Also, perfect parking job. Did you see that? Perfect parking job. Skippy skippy cutscene. Very good. Also, I won't collect any hidden packages, I won't do any side missions. I'll get all my weapons from just playing around and searching for them. If I can find them, I'll get them. I know a few locations for weapons, but not all the locations. I usually just, you know, collect all hidden packages and then I get lots of weapons that way. But this time I have to rely on my knowledge on weapon locations. And my knowledge is pretty limited because I don't usually take them from spawn locations, I just take them from my safe house. When I collect 100 king packages. You gotta pack some heat. Local gun shop's a couple of blocks away. And here's Lion Sipu. Welcome Lion Sipu to Vice City. Or some people suggest that I call him Lion Sipu. Because you know, in my Vice City stories walkthrough, I call him Lion Sipu. And some people said, hey, call him Lion Sipu. Or Lion Sipu shit. And okay, he's Lion Sipu shit. Hey, Lion Sipu shit, what you doing? Lion Sipu sounds better. I mean, I want to be nice to the guy. He's working with me. And so far, in this first video, at least, I have not bought a single weapon. I don't wanna buy weapons. Cause they take money, and I wanna buy properties later. So if you use my money on these weapons, I won't be able to buy properties. Now, in my playthrough of the GTA 3 mod, Winter mod, I did not have enough money for the last mission. I needed 500,000 bucks. I did not have enough money. So I had to do some extra things in order to get the money.
I'm gonna go see what I can dig up. I'll be watching you, Tommy.
And I don't want the same to happen here too. So I'll try to not spend too much cash on useless crap. For instance, buying weapons is a waste. Because there's weapons everywhere. I can get them in missions, I can get them in spawn locations, if I remember the spawn locations, of course. So it's kind of a waste, and I won't do it. At least for now. In the future, if, for instance, if I die in a mission and I lose all my weapons, of course I'm gonna go buy them. If there's no other alternative, I'll just buy them. And bloop! Idiot. That hammer would be useful.
Florida moron.
Not actually because I have a gun. Normally at the beginning you should not have a gun, but I got a gun. Because I'm hardcore. I'm joking. Now this vehicle is one of the worst vehicles to use because it's so slow. It's so mega slidey, it's so heavy. Yeah, I don't like this vehicle that much. I'm also down some health, which is not good. There's a armor to the right of me. I should have taken, but nah. Dude, learn to drive! Holy crap! That idiot jumped to my car. 300 bucks so far, it's not a lot. So usually here I have the other weapons, but this is gonna do just fine.
I can't believe this is happening.
Innocent until I say otherwise.
I usually have the chainsaw here, which is a lot better, but the gun works well too. Why not? There's also speedrun mechanics which you can use. You know, some people glitch out the game in a way to make the other vehicle just explode on its own. But I don't want to use that tactic because it makes the game so cheap. Now, this game can be completed in 4 minutes. From start, actually 4 or 5 minutes, I'm not sure, but in 4 or 5 minutes it can be completed with glitches. That's such a waste. Why would I play this game if I'm gonna complete it at 4 or 5 minutes? Yeah, guys, you can just glitch out the game and it's gonna give you the last mission pretty much at the start. Yeah. It's so cheap, such a cheap trick, I don't wanna do that. Sorry, wait for this guy to crash and to destroy his car. Usually you can use that hammer.
Remember Giorgio? Remember he's innocent?
But using the gun is also good. This car tried to explode many times, but since, you know, I was in a cutscene, it did not explode. The one which I turned over. Trying to get vehicles and they're not spawning, I'm not looking for a police vehicle, go away. Also, it seems to me... Wait a second, I have to listen to this.
Hey, Leo, I think we got a buyer for Diaz merchandise. Gotta give him a ring, man. Set up a deal, you know?
Where are you now?
You okay, Leo? You sound kinda different.
Just tell me where you are.
Who the hell is this? Put Leo on, man.
Leo's gone away for a while. He left me in charge.
Screw you, man.
The reflections are amazing
Leave
in this game.
Lady alone.
So much better. So many cops everywhere. Stop. Stop spawning so much. Yeah, that's one of the biggest downsides of this game. The overabundance of cops. They're not actually cops, they're FBI agents, I guess. I think so.
All in the line of police duty, huh?
No, 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 don't! Oh, I don't actually remember if I got busted or not. I played this a few days ago. So, I forgot some things I did. I think 3 days ago, I'm not sure, right before New Year's, and I'm probably gonna upload this, probably on the 3rd, of the new year. It's gonna be one of my first videos of the year, yay, of 2017, that is. Okay, next mission, what do we have to do? I was not paying attention, I was not looking at the screen even, so... Oh yeah, I'm gonna go pick up the weapon, yeah! I remember a shotgun location, this shotgun is super helpful at the beginning. You should totally get it. I was also not sure of the exact location, I just knew it was behind a bench, and there we go. There's a shotgun, this is super helpful for this mission. And for other missions too. You'll see me using it constantly in some missions. So where's the... I have to go to the left, dude, left side. In GTA Vice City Stories, this here is a Ferris wheel location. You can just crush these guys. Or you can fight them if you want to. You can crush all of them if you want to, but this works too. Destroy, come on! And destroy, there's no explodable objects here. Stop screaming, I have to talk louder! And there we go, we can just escape and the mission's gonna be passed. Also, you may have seen that the crosshair is not correct. What do I mean by that? Well, you have a crosshair and you have a little dot on the crosshair. That dot is not accurate at all. If you play the original game, the dot is completely accurate. But here it is not. I actually did not see this in the first video, but when I was recording the second video, I noticed it. And it's so annoying.
Mr. Versetti?
Yeah.
This is Cortez.
were at my party?
Yeah, I remember.
Mr. Versetti, it was a most unfortunate incident that happened with your business deal.
I know.
I want you to know me and my people are doing their utmost to get to the bottom of it. If you'd like to talk to me more privately, you can find me at the boat. Okay? Good day, senor.
Now, this mission is not required for game completion, but unfortunately, I forgot. As I said, guys, I was not preparing Caro. This was just blind. So I decided to do it, why not? So let's go to the golf club. Golf course. So, for the crosshair, this is a huge issue with this mod. This is why I don't like this mod. It's a nice mod and all that, a few new things, few cool features, but that is the most annoying, because this game is Grand Theft Auto. In Grand Theft Auto games, the main focus is shooting and driving. If you take away my shooting, my enjoyment of shooting, this is not an enjoyable game, right? Because half the game is shooting, probably even more than half the game is shooting. So if it's not accurate, it's not useful to me. You'll see what I mean in the next video. For this one first video, it's not that abundantly clear that it's a huge problem, but in the second video, you're gonna see that. It's a huge issue. So let's go. Now currently, if I get inside the golf course through that door, I would lose all my weapons, and I want to use my weapons in this mission. So what I'm gonna do, you just jump on this and jump in there. There we go. I lost some health, but I know of a spawn location for a heart close by, so we can take it on the way. And I have to kill a dude. This is why I took a shotgun. In this mission, you'll see the problem with the crosshair too. Right now. When I get close to him. Watch out, dude. Don't fall in the water, that will be super foolish of you. If you fall in the water, you're stupid. There we go, as you can see, it's not accurate. Arrow, I'm shooting it straight at him. Now, you can see the crosshair. The weapons fire a little bit above the crosshair. And I ran out of ammo for the shotgun. Unfortunately, so now I have to chase him. I gotta say, I have never in my life chased this guy. I have always took him down with a sniper or with a gun, whatever gun. I have never chased this guy. In all my times of completing this game, this is my first time chasing him. So I had no idea what to do. I have never seen anybody chase him. I have never chased him myself, so it was completely new to me. And look what happened. I fell in the water. The good news is that he also fell in the water. So look what's gonna happen. Mission passed. I hit 6 HP before I died.
Hey Tommy, it's Sonny. How's the suntan?
I ain't got no suntan.
We ain't got my money either, so I'm running it myself. What are you doing? So tell me, Tommy, what are you doing?
I'm looking for the money, Sonny. Don't worry.
I am worrying, Tommy. That's my style, because I seem to have this problem in my life. With unreliable people. Don't be an unreliable person, Tommy, please. Do us both a favor. I'm looking forward to hearing from you.
As I was saying before I got rudely interrupted,
don't tell the police about this.
This was the best thing that happened in this video. Seriously, I completed the mission, I had 6 HP left. If he died 6 HP later, like probably 3 seconds later, I would have failed the mission. And it was not an important mission I had to do. So it was okay.
Get to the payphone next to the mall in Washington.
If I failed it. So if I enter this vehicle, it's gonna give me armor. I tried to do that, but this was locked. Sometimes it's not locked, sometimes it is. This time I did not have luck and it was locked. In the future, hopefully it's gonna be unlocked for future missions. I'm gonna pass through this place and I'm gonna try to get into it, and we shall see if it is. Okay, so the next location for armor is over here. It's also on the way to the next mission, so why not? Oh, and also, after that mission completed, I remembered that Avery's missions are not required for game completion. So I'm not gonna do them. Actually, many of the missions are not required, like the Cuban missions, the Haitian missions, Avery's missions, Mitch Baker's missions. Many missions are not required. So of course I won't do them. This is a playthrough of me playing how I normally play these games when I'm not recording. So this is how I play and this is how you watch. Hopefully you're gonna watch all of this. Hopefully you enjoy. And hopefully you have a good time. Also, this game is glitchy. This mod is glitchy. It crashes, so try to save as much as I can. I'm not sure if I saved a lot. Oh yes, I did save at the second video. I'm not sure if I saved in the first video. Huh. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I did not save. Okay, that's fine, that's fine. So in the first video, I'll only unlock the first island. The starfish island, yeah. In the first video, I'll unlock the starfish island. In the next video, I'll probably unlock the second island. Yeah, I'll unlock the second island. And probably... I don't know how far I'm gonna reach, actually. We shall see. Just wait. So what's this mission? I was not paying attention. Is it the French guy? Do I have to kill the French guy? Pretty sure I have to. Is it? No, it's not. The French guy is next. Okay, what was this mission? Oh, is this where we see Lance again? I'm pretty sure it is. No, it's not. What is this mission? I should pay more attention, you know. I should also get some weapons. Mm-hmm. Alex, go pick up some weapons right now. He's not listening to me. Anyway, I don't need weapons for this mission, so I won't use weapons. Many weapons, that is. Okay, let's go. We have to kill this dude. He's on the roof. Also, I thought my game bugged out. But it didn't. Oh, I had a weapon. Okay. And straight shot. Awesome. I have two cop stars, which is fine. I'm gonna pick up this one first. And I'm just running and try to pick up a vehicle. I could have gone back, but it was a dangerous place. So, what I thought to do was go to Pay and Spray. But on the way I said, ah, you know what? I don't need to do that. I can just go to my next mission and just wait for the star to disappear. That's it. There's also a bribe location pretty close by, but I did not remember of that location straight away. But after I recorded the video, after I watched it back, I remembered the star location, which I could have gotten. I also almost killed that dude. If I killed him, it would have been an issue because I would have gotten my star back. So, next mission for Cortez. Let's go. We have to do pretty much all the missions, not all the missions for Cortez, but most of the missions I have to do to complete this game. The last mission is not required, so I don't have to do it. I could have also saved, it was a good idea to save there, but I didn't. Because I'm worried. This game could crash at any second. And all of this would be for nothing. You would have not seen that amazing caddy jump in the water if the game crashed. Seriously, that was amazing. It was a fail on my part, yeah. I could have done it a lot better, but no, I didn't. And it was super funny to me. When I did it, I was laughing so much. I hope you were too. I don't know. And this is the French guy. Let's go to the French guy. And I'll try to kill him, of course. It's also where the shotgun comes in handy. That's where you should take it. Park close by. And this is the method I used in my walkthrough. Just go as fast as possible, chasing him, just jump backwards and start chasing him. Not on a bike, he's gonna go on a bike. You can go on foot and just shoot him from far away. Like this. Direct shot. That was super amazing. I gotta say, with my crosshair problems, this was a straight shot. If this was on the original game, this would not have been a straight shot because the crosshair is not accurate, yeah. So anyway, I lost lots of health there, which I could get back if I want to. This bike is super terrible in this mod. This is most likely the worst vehicle to use. Seriously, it's super fast, yeah, it's an amazing vehicle, probably the best vehicle in the original game, but here it slides all over the place and it's a bike, so a bike sliding is not very good, because you fall constantly. Guardian Angels, let's see. Fire Popper. Oh yeah, yeah, this is an amazing mission, yeah, this is Diaz's mission. This is the last mission in this city, yeah. After this mission I unlock Starfish Island. So after this I'll end the video, of course. I'll try to keep every single video at about half an hour, maybe 40 minutes, I'll try not to make them an hour long. Many people would enjoy an hour long videos, but many people would also not watch them, so I prefer having a middle ground. 30 minutes is fine, in my opinion, so I'll try to make them 30 minutes. Also, I should not drive with this bike often. It doesn't drive good, man. It just doesn't. It slides super much. So, I have a new gun. This gun is super cool. I'll try not to use it in this mission, so I can use it in other missions in the future. And if I die, of course, I'll lose it, so it's kind of a waste not using it here, because I could die in the next mission and lose it. But yeah, I'll try to keep it, I'll try not to use it that much. And I'll try to use the Uzis that I'll pick up in this mission. Or the shotgun, of course, which is also super helpful. Or the chainsaw, which is also helpful. Yeah, chainsaw is super good for this mission especially. And especially with this mod, you'll see why with this mod the chainsaw is even more useful. Come on, dude. And here's Diaz. I can't skip this, by the way. You have to watch it.
You must be Cortez's new gun.
Until more gainful opportunities arise.
They'll be here any minute. We both better get a good vantage point.
Okay, I'll take the balcony. You get the roof across the yard.
Grudy Lance, you're completely useless in this mission, however, so... So let's watch out for these guys. Let's wait for the other people to come. So these guys are talking, I don't have to stay on the balcony. I just have to watch over these guys, I don't have to watch directly at them, of course. And these guys are affected by the snow too, which makes this mission so much easier, because I can just use the chainsaw. Right over here. Look at this. Chainsaw these guys up, and chainsaw the other guys up, like this and like this. Just chainsaw every single person. I'll pick up some Uzis, of course. And the crosshair is not accurate, so I'm trying to shoot correctly, but no, it's not working. It's the most annoying thing about this mission, this mod, not mission. It's okay, I'll try not to complain too much about it, because it's probably annoying you people to hear all constant complaining about this, but still, it has to be mentioned. Okay.
Some help here.
Of course you do, you can't shoot for shit.
My money.
This mod, however, is gonna help me here too, with these people, because they're also affected by the snow.
There,
tried to shoot him, but I couldn't. So just tried to go closer and just shoot him from the bike. I usually shoot him from far away, but this time it could not. It did not happen because I did not practice, of course. And he's affected, so he was a lot slower, and I got him quickly. Let's go back to Diaz. Let's talk to that dude. And he will unlock the second island, not the second island, but the Starfish Island. He's gonna unlock Starfish Island for us, yay! I couldn't stop in time, so I just jumped out.
I live!
You do, unfortunately.
It's all down to you. What is your name?
Tommy.
Versetti.
I'll see you soon, amigo, I think.
That's Mr. Versetti. Tommy, don't call yourself Tommy.
Where's that guy, Lance?
It's Mr. Versetti. And that's it, guys. I unlocked these seconds, or Starfish Island, I should say. I'll go to my safe location, save the game, probably listen to a phone call by Diaz himself. And I'll end this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope you stick around for the other parts. This is gonna be super cool. Woohoo! Amazing jump, I gotta say.
Tommy, it's Ricardo Diaz. I want to thank you for looking out for me, my man. I heard that prick Cortez, he said you're the real deal, my friend. Will you not come see me? I need a guy like you. All I have now is dickheads. Dickheads everywhere, yo. I make you real rich.
I'm sure you will. And that guy's unlocked Starfish Island, as you can see. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'll save the game, and I'll see you in the next video.